Welcome back, dear. We completed with the common noun, right? So next type is collective noun. Collective noun, you could have learnt in fourth standard, right? Collective noun is a word for a group of specific items, animals or people. For example, a group of ships. How will you call a group of ships? A fleet. Group of cows are grazing in the field. How will you call it? A herd. A group of lions is called as a pride. A group of baseball players or whatever players it is, maybe football players, cricket players, they are all called as team. Group of ants, colony. Okay, so all these are represented as a collective noun when we are specifically informing about a team or a group. And what you are calling about your group, you're calling as class, a class of students, right? Next comes abstract noun. Abstract noun, it's little bit difficult for you to understand in the initial stages. An abstract noun is something that you cannot feel by the five senses. You know what are the sensory organs? Your sensory organs are eyes, then nose, ear, tongue and your hand. Then what are the senses? There are differences between sense organs and senses, right? Sense organs are eyes. What is a sense? Seeing. Seeing is a sense. Tongue is a organ, sense organ. Sense is tasting. And ear is a sense organ. Hearing is a sense. Nose is a sense organ. And smelling is a sense. Okay. Hand is an organ. And touching is a sense. So, what are the five senses? Seeing, tasting, smelling, hearing and touching. When you are not aware of all these, then you cannot understand abstract noun. Here, if you cannot feel this five senses, you cannot touch it. You cannot see it. You cannot taste it. You cannot hear it. What is a word called? For example, I am saying, he is a very good boy. Good here represent what? Yes, here good is a adjective. Very good. Then, if I am saying, lion is meant for its bravery. Here, bravery means what? Can you able to see bravery? Can you able to smell, touch or taste it? Nothing. So, if you cannot sense by your five senses, that set of nouns are called as abstract noun. Health. How can you say that you are healthy? Freedom. How can you say that India got freedom? We are learning in history, 1947, India got freedom from British, etc., etc., all the stories we are reading. Mahatma Gandhiji, father of our nation, right? All these we are reading. Then what is the meaning of freedom? So freedom cannot be sensed. It can be felt. That feeling is called as an abstract noun. An abstract noun, abstract nouns are the words that are not concrete. You cannot sense it with the physical senses, right? In essence, the quality, the concept, an idea, it may be an event also, right? For example, I'm giving you a max puzzle. I'm asking you answer, right? You doesn't know the answer, but you are trying to answer it by your guessing. So the word guess is an abstract noun, right? So all these are considered as abstract noun. Children, when you read more and more books and newspaper, then you will come to a conclusion of what is a noun, proper noun, common noun, abstract noun, all these, right? So try, watch out the news channels, English news channels particularly, not Tamil news channels. English news channel, if you are watching Chinchan or any other cartoon also, you try to watch in English, right? This has to be written in your classwork, right? Take your index page, write today's date, then write grammar, in bracket you write noun, okay? Then go inside the classwork. You could have finished first lesson, prose. What is the name of the lesson? Yes? Name of the first lesson. Don't know, dear. Who did? Patrick's homework. And the poem. Next comes a poem. A house, a home. Next comes a tale of two birds. All these three you could have completed in your classwork, right? So go to the next page, write grammar on the top. You continue in the same notebook, same next continuation. No need to segregate the notebooks, right? First write grammar on the top. Date is very, very important. Then write grammar and noun in the black pen. Leave one line and write noun is the name given to a thing, person, object or feeling. Commas has to be placed properly. Okay, wherever full stop is there, you have to keep full stop. Comma has to be there. All punctuation has to be proper. Handwriting should be right side slanting. Very neat handwriting should be there. Okay. Example, Ram, comma, man, dog, book, tree, light, love, extra. Right? What doubt you have in this? Right. Can we write Ram, man, dog, all these down one by one in the next line? No, it is not necessary to write like that because it is all just small words and all these are examples of noun only, right? So leave one line, draw a line over here, go to kinds of noun. One, common noun. Two, proper noun. Three is collective noun. Four is abstract noun. And five is material noun. All these one by one you have to write and these number has to be within the margin. It should not go out of the margin. If it goes out of the margin, it is considered as question number. It has to be inside the margin itself. Is it clear how to write your classwork? Next is proper noun in black pen. Leave one line and write a proper noun is a special word that we use for a person, place or organization. Example, you write any example as you wish. Your name also can be written or anything can be written here. Any doubt in this? A name is a noun but a very special noun, a proper noun. This three lines is also enough for proper noun. Any doubt in proper noun? So all these should be in your classwork. Common noun. Write the heading common noun. In black pen, leave one line, blue pen. Next, a common noun is used to name general things, places, ideas, events or people. Even their official names or titles such as teacher, preacher, clerk, police officer, delivery driver, grandma and cousins are common nouns. Right? Draw a line over there and then collective noun. Write the definition. A collective noun is a word for a group of specific items, animals or people. Example, a group of ships is called a fleet. A group of cows is called a herd. A group of lions is called a pride. A group of baseball player is called a team. Group of ants is called a colony. Children, one thing you have to notice in this, what is that? A is a singular, right? Group of ships. Here, ships represent plural form, isn't it? But after plural form, we are using the word is. Is has to be represented for singular, right? But why we are using after ships? Check it out. Cows, plural. But after cows, we are using is. Lions, plural. After that, is. Again, players, plural. After that, is. Ants, is. So, you have to notice all these. What is the difference? Because a group of ships is considered as one here. One single team. One single word. That is why it is used as a singular form. And it is called as fleet, herd, pride, team and colony. Right? Is it clear for you? Now comes abstract noun. So underline that. Write in black pen. Leave one line. An abstract noun is a word which names something that you cannot see, hear, touch, smell or taste. Right? So example for this, I gave 10 example and you can write any 5 in this. Underline the word which is an abstract noun. First example, we have to get at the truth of the matter. Here, what is an abstract noun? Truth. Gossips. Faith. Defeat. Success. Idea. Fear. Anger. Strength. Evil. All these are abstract noun which I used in my sentence. This is all my own sentence. And you have to write your own sentence. 5 or 10 sentences using abstract noun. Right? Shall we? Right. So, any doubts in this, children? Very good. I hope you will understand this. And if you have any doubts, you please contact us at any time. Thank you, dear. Bye.